Welcome to this gathering of souls seeking nourishment. We come hungry for connection, for community, for meaning, and for action. We come to feed our spirits and to tend our hearts. And we gather to nourish ourselves and others, an interwoven community of humans finding our way together. We light our chalice this morning to tend the fire, which is our way to resilience. We kindle this flame to nurture the fire of love and to spread it to others. May we offer a welcome table to all in a spirit of deep generosity as we begin with our opening hymn, Welcome Table.
Welcome to All Souls Church Unitarian. I'm Sherry Gilbert. Everybody asks me how I pronounce my name. I just say my name's Sherry Gilbert, so however you interpret that, it's so funny. Anyway, I'm your worship associate this morning. My pronouns are she, her. We gather at All Souls in person or on Zoom, accepting each of us as we are today, where we accept all gender identities, sexual orientation, abilities, race, and religion. We gather to celebrate our successes with others or to seek comfort when in pain. We gather to be present with ourselves and others on this day that has been given to us. I'd like to extend a special welcome to those this morning who are new or newly returning. I saw some people who I know I haven't seen since before the pandemic. It's just great to see you in person here again today. If you are new here, please raise your hand in person, or if you're new on Zoom, you can raise your hand in the chat so we can give you a warm welcome. If you're here this morning in the sanctuary, you can access the order of service by the QR code in front of you in the pew, and I think it's the one to the right. We do have a few printed programs. We may be out of those, so share if you can. For those on Zoom, the order of service is in the chat. Our weekly newsletter is a great way to stay up to date on all the upcoming offerings of the church community. If you're not currently subscribed, please sign up through the link on the All Souls website homepage. All Souls recognizes that our city and church built on lands taken from indigenous people. We lament this injustice. The closest village to our church site was Nacotchtank, from which the name Anacostia is derived. The residents were a part of the Piscataway group of tribes that are present in DC and the Maryland region. Those peoples remain in the region to this day. If you're joining us from further away, I encourage you to research the native peoples of the land where you reside or are visiting. And for all of us who aren't native to this land, one way to practice our commitment to the eighth principle is to find out what native organizing is happening in your area and how you can support it. Now is the time we call beholding. If you're on Zoom, open your gallery screen and greet each other. We can now see each other in the sanctuary on those screens. Sometimes, usually. If you're in the sanctuary. Oh, there they are. Great. Hello. If you are in the sanctuary, please greet each other in the manner most comfortable to you, an embrace, a fist bump, or an elbow bump. Let's greet. Continue our conversations and greetings after the service. And again, welcome to All Souls Church.
Justice does not allow that the sacrifices imposed on a few are outweighed by the larger sum of advantages enjoyed by the many.
Let us find. Hello, all souls. I'm Reverend Bill Sinkford. My pronouns are he and him. And I have a number of things to announce and for you to get on your calendars. The 45th anniversary concert of the Jubilee Singers is fast approaching. It'll be December 3rd, Saturday at 7 p.m. It will be a night of amazing celebration and song. Tickets are available at the website. Cost is $20, but cost will not be a barrier to anyone who wants to attend. And I hope to see many of you there that evening. And the holiday season is here. Have you noticed? Has penetrated your consciousness? With many opportunities to regather and reconnect in celebration and in service as the holiday traditions at All Souls call us together once again. Volunteers have been putting the food bags together for the Thanksgiving food drive in Pierce Hall. You might want to stop by Pierce Hall after the service to see if any more volunteers are needed, particularly people who might be able to make a quick run to the store to complete and balance out the bags, the last bags that we put together. Pierce Hall, on your way to the Reeb Lobby, where coffee hour will be this afternoon, and where the caring table has been set up. And if you need some sustenance so that you can take part in the after-service activities, or if you're just hungry, the high schoolers are serving pancake breakfast downstairs in the dining room right after the service as well, and they would love some volunteers who might be able to help the cleanup after the pancake breakfast has been served. Remember that the last day to deliver your contributions for the toy collection for La Clinica is December 9th at noon. Toys are needed for all ages of children. Unwrapped, please. The collection bins are in the Reeb Lobby. And you can come help decorate the sanctuary tree on December 6th. That's at 5:30. We'll listen to some Christmas music, maybe sing a few carols, decorate the tree, and then head to the Reeb Lobby to decorate cookies. The children's choir will take the lead in this intergenerational event, but we will need some older folks who are still children at heart who can climb the ladder to adorn the top branches of the tree. And there's more, the Arts and Crafts Fair, the Ornament Exchange, caroling, the pageant on the 11th, and holiday worship services themselves. This is a full winter holiday calendar, once again here at the church. All of the details are at the website, and there's also a link to the full schedule in your order of service. It's a busy, and this is a wonderful season at All Souls. Now, we transition from announcements and calendaring into the space where we hear the concerns of members of this community. Being present to one another in time of need and transition is a central part of our ministry together. And the holiday season, for all of its joys, can be hard for many of us as well. Member Stephen Greenwater's mother, Linda Stratford, died last Monday after living with pancreatic cancer. She was 73 and a longtime leader at the Raleigh North Carolina UU Fellowship. She was also a longtime fan of All Souls, and she included the All Souls community on her list of prayer angels who were holding her through her illness. Let us be prayer angels for her spirit as she wished, and for Stephen and Kendra, who may be here this morning, and that entire family in this time of loss. And we are holding Susan Milner and her family in Columbus, Ohio. Her father was rehospitalized there this week, and he has decided to enter hospice care. We send love to the whole family in this time of transition. We also hold the members of the transgender community, including the All Souls members with that identity, on this Transgender Day of Remembrance. This day asks all of us to remember the lives lost to anti-trans violence including lives lost just last night at the shooting in the club in Colorado. The day asks us to remember those who face violence on a daily basis, and to remember those who worry for friends and loved ones, especially children. If we are transgender, may we feel ourselves held by this community and by the spirit of life and of love. And if we are not trans, may our love help this world end violence against people simply because of who they are. On this day of remembrance, let us all promise not to forget. The DC Transgender Day Remembrance Vigil will take place at the MCC Church on Ridge Street Northwest. That'll be at 6 this evening, and all of us are welcome. Now, into the silence, you can speak the names of those folks that you are holding in your heart on this day, or for those on the Zoom, in the Zoom space, you can write those names in the chat. Will you pray with me now? Spirit of life, presence of love, dear God, be with us. Help us hold our hearts open so that we can know your presence both when we celebrate and when we mourn, when we are at peace, and when our lives are troubled by personal challenges or the failures of our world. Help us hold it all, and help us remember that we are part of everything that we hold. May we find that we too are held in ways that are hard to describe but real nonetheless. Help us put down the illusion of our separateness and embrace the connectedness that is real, that is true. We pray for that wholeness for ourselves and promise to do our part, however small, by our living, to help love live in this world, feeding our bodies and our spirits, leaving none of us behind. May that be so. Ashe and amen.
Thank you.
And for all those names and situations that were spoken aloud or in the chat or in our hearts, we say blessings and amen. Our reading this morning is by the Reverend Angela Herrera, and it's a poem called In the Food Pantry Line. The day before Thanksgiving, a woman in a beautiful beaded dress, a man with no teeth, a young man with a pierced lip, and one in his 40s covered with tattoos. Several young mothers, a crowd of little girls, and boys flipping and turning on a rail and hopping up our sanctuary steps. Our steps, but their steps as well, if we mean it, this inherent worth and dignity. And if there's an interdependent web, and we didn't just make it up, their steps, if we get radical and believe that love is justice and welcome people in. Their steps, if we overcome our fear that we'll be overwhelmed by need. What's ours is theirs. 15 children and 70 adults the day before Thanksgiving on the sanctuary steps. So we're in the season of eating for many of us, Thanksgiving week. And it's a good moment to ponder what nourishes you. Is it a special recipe? Is it a communal gathering? Or maybe the chance to do good with generosity and heart? And here's the thing. When you give to others, you feed your own spirit. So many people in our area and some in our church community do not have enough to eat. Food scarcity has risen greatly as a result of the pandemic. And according to Feeding America, in the District of Columbia, one in 11 people is hungry, and one in six are children. 65,000 people regularly face hunger right here in DC. And it's so easy for this to stay abstract, a number that is somehow removed from us, rather than be touched directly by this fact. So how can we make it real? Today we are offering you a few ways to act, and every one of us can do something. In Pierce Hall, we are gathering food for partner organizations, making over 300 bags for families this week, and the amount of food and cash donations for that has been so generous. Thank you. This Thanksgiving collection is our first live one since 2019, and it's a tradition at All Souls for over 60 years. You might have ordered or brought food or packed bags as your way to contribute. And I hope this nourishes your own spirit. I know it will nourish those who receive your contributions. Most of you have seen our beautiful Little Free Pantry on 15th Street. It's big and blue, so it's very hard to miss. A steady stream of people stops by there, so food clears out fast. Bringing something to that pantry will feed your soul, and every person who receives it benefits. And here's a simple challenge for the future. Each time you get groceries, you can get a few extra items to feed others. And every time you come to All Souls, you might put something in that pantry. We've just begun to reach the potential of what we can give at that site. Now, the grant to build our Little Free Pantry came from the nonprofit No Child Goes Hungry, which gives funds to 32 states for food advocacy. And grant recipients are free to imagine how they want to feed hungry kids. There are community garden projects, student backpacks with food, food trucks, food rescue programs, and lots of little free pantries. No Child Goes Hungry was created by UU minister, the Reverend Karin Rasmussen. And Karin's very bright idea became a reality over time through her time and energy and generosity. I've been inspired by her desire to take concrete action on this very large issue of childhood hunger, one project at a time. Karin is here today. Can we give her a shout out? If she could wave. Two years ago, I asked about writing a children's book to benefit No Child Goes Hungry, which is my own idea of how to contribute. A fantastic artist, Penny Weber, illustrated and helped the story come to life. And we have been on this learning adventure in publishing. Today, we launch our new book, At All Souls. Yeah! You can see it, you can buy a signed copy at a table in the Reeb lobby. And all the proceeds go to No Child Goes Hungry, and then on to new grants for more communities. So please consider buying this beautiful book to nourish your own spirits of generosity and as a gift to others of any age. I'm a big fan of children's books to inspire, no matter how old you are. Now, Emilio's very bright idea tells the story of one boy who heard about kids who were hungry and decided he could do something. It is based in Petworth, D.C., where we live across the street from Truesdale School and in front of a community garden. There was a young boy who used to come to school alone very early, and I often met him while out with our dog. This child had a beautiful, enthusiastic spirit about everything, and he was the inspiration for Emilio. I thought about how to describe this story, and then I thought, well, may I read you a story for all ages today? It's about Emilio's spark of imagination that made a very bright idea come to life. It's about a boy who inspired action in his own community and taught others about spreading love with food. So this is Emilio's very bright idea. Every morning, Emilio Antonio Santos de la O walked to school exactly the same way. Now that he was in the third grade, Emilio walked the four blocks alone. He had his key on a straw sombrero chain from San Miguel de Allende, Mexico, where his grandmother lived. And he first walked along the big community garden and shouted out, "Hi there," to Mr. Cleo Badgett, who was digging in the soft dirt. Mr. Badgett had rows and rows of corn, climbing tomato plants, and baby squash growing on long vines. Then Emilio counted the 13 peach trees that were in the garden. He saw how the hard green fruit was ripening, and he said, "Good morning, peach trees." Next, he walked over to the house with his favorite little dog, Whopper, and the Buddha statue in front. "Hello, Buddha. Hello, Whopper." Finally, Emilio landed in the school playground and went up the climbing tower. He sat very high on top, and he watched all the people come into the school like birds flying into a very big nest. Now, after looking for a long time, the siren of the day. After looking for a long time, Emilio climbed down and went into his school, Truesdell Elementary, just before the bell rang. His first class that morning was his favorite, social studies. His teacher, Mr. James Dixon, began showing lots of slides with children's faces and numbers. He explained how all around the city of Washington, D.C., all over the USA, and the world, kids were too hungry. And even at Truesdell Elementary School, too many kids were hungry. Emilio's face began to scrunch as he thought about it. He knew some students ate breakfast in the cafeteria before school started and also got lunches with vouchers. And then a memory of his grandmother, Abuelita Corazon, popped into his head. He loved to visit her in Mexico in the summer with his parents, and he always asked for the same birthday dish. Emilio loved mole enchiladas, dark, spicy chili sauce with grated chocolate poured over hot, handmade corn tortillas with melty cheese. And when Abuelita put that steaming plate on the table, she always shouted the same words and gave Emilio a big hug. La comida es amor, mijo. La comida es amor. Now in social studies class, Emilio's arms started to wave in the air like the flag on the school pole in high wind. And Mr. Dixon sighed and said, Emilio, what is so important that you have to say it right away? Emilio took a deep breath, and he thought about all the hungry children in the pictures, and Abuelita's voice was singing in his head, so he yelled out very fast, La comida es amor! Well, the class giggled and wiggled in their seats, and Mr. Dixon stared at Emilio and said, Excuse me? What does that mean? Emilio repeated more slowly, La comida es amor. Abuelita always says this. It means food is love. Mr. Dixon, hungry kids at Truesdell need to eat because they need love. We have to do something. There was silence in the room, and now everyone stared at Emilio. Mr. Dixon sat down on the edge of his desk, and he put down the remote control. And then he spoke slowly. What do you think we need to do, Emilio? Emilio Antonio Santos de la O thought very hard, and he wasn't sure what to say. He wished his arm had never flown up in the air like the flag on the school pole. And then a tiny idea suddenly came to Emilio, like a little light bulb popping on. And he said, what if hungry kids could go to a pantry at the front of our school and just take something home to eat? Emilio spoke faster now as his idea was growing brighter. We could build a little free pantry. Food would come in all the time. Food would go out all the time, right here at the school. Mr. Dixon seemed surprised, and he nodded his head as Emilio's idea kept shining in the classroom. Emilio, you just had a very bright idea. Now at lunch, Emilio's friends ran to catch up, wanting to talk about the very bright idea. Sunya Parikh and Eddie Cruz and Omari Jackson were also excited because it was Friday, their favorite lunch day, pizza. And they each said what they would bring to the pantry for hungry kids. Omari said she would bring peanuts. She liked the thick, sweet peanut and kale stew her Auntie Flo made in South Carolina. And Sunya was going to bring in chickpeas. Yeah, she loved to cook chana masala with her older brother and pour the spicy tomato sauce over basmati rice. And Eddie Cruz would contribute peanut butter and strawberry jelly. His mom was an architect and made little sandwiches in tower shapes with cookie cutters. Emilio knew exactly what he would bring, the dark, unsweetened chocolate for mole sauce, the kind in Abuelita's kitchen. Now, when he left school that day, Emilio passed the front steps and he imagined a new wooden cabinet of food sitting right there. He could see it now, a little free pantry to hold food for hungry kids. It took a while for the little free pantry to be built. First, Emilio needed to explain his very bright idea to more grown-ups. And then money had to be raised and supplies purchased. People worked together to cut wood and build the cabinet and paint the pantry in bright colors. Finally, it was all done. And Emilio and his parents put the first food in the little free pantry. They opened the shiny purple and green doors that smelled like wood and fresh paint. And they put rice, beans, tortillas, chili powder, and dark chocolate inside. Emilio's very bright idea was real. Truesdale Elementary School had a big potluck dinner to celebrate. There was chana masala, basmati rice. There was peanut and kale stew. There were peanut butter and jelly banana towers, and enchiladas with mole sauce. There were Friday cheese pizzas too, and Mr. James Dixon brought the little packages of Oreos that everyone loved. There were fresh pies from the peaches in the community garden. At the very end of the first ever Truesdale Picnic Fiesta, there was a special speaker. Abuelita Corazon flew in from Mexico to celebrate the little free pantry. She stood up on a milk crate and shouted in a very excited voice, "Don't forget, mijos, la comida es amor. Food is love." The end. Thank you for listening. Let's go feed some hungry kids.
That is a great story for all ages. Thank you. So when I was composing this offertory in my head, it started sounding familiar to me. I looked back through my files and yep, this is a bit of a rerun. If you were here on the Sunday before Thanksgiving in 2018, this will also sound familiar to you. Thank you, God, for our dear home, for father and for mother, for milk and bread and jam to spread and share with one another. We grew up saying that prayer every night before dinner. When visiting my dad's family in Virginia, we said, "Give us grateful hearts, O Lord, for these blessings which we are about to receive. In Christ's name, amen." My vegan family members sing, bear with me, "Thank you for this food, this glorious, wonderful food, for the animals and the vegetables and the minerals that made it possible." Thank you. Today, this is my prayer of gratitude. Dear All Souls Church, thank you, Reverend Sinkfort, Keithan, and Green. Thank you, Tracy Hughes Trotter. Thank you, All Souls staff, music directors, choirs, custodians, coffee hour setup folks, RE teachers, greeters, and ushers. Thank you, choirs, ASL interpreters, sound folks, board members, and trustees. Thank you, all volunteers. Thank you for anyone I may have left out. Thank you, congregants and fellow worship associates. Thank you, All Souls, for being here, rain or shine, during protests and celebrations. Thank you for welcoming me on bad hair days. Thank you. Thank you for keeping the doors open on days I'm late. and thank you for forgiving me when I stumble. I am stronger because of you. Thank you, all souls. If you are in the sanctuary, the ushers will be passing the plate for our offering. You can also text to All Souls by sending ASCU to 37256. If you're on Zoom, click the link in the chat, which will direct you to All Souls online giving. Thank you for your generous support of All Souls, and happy Thanksgiving.
Just give us a second to get the rest of our friends up here. Little crowd. Yeah, man. Thank you for rising in body or spirit for our closing hymn. We're going to do this a little different. This is a new one, so we want to make sure that you really know what you're doing. We're going to let the rhythm section take over as we lead you.
For justice starts with a very bright idea. What is yours? Nurture it into reality with the courage of your convictions that we might change the world for the better. Go in peace and practice love. Amen. Thank you.